Welcome to another tutorial in my tutorial series AutoCAD 2D Technical Drawing. Today I would like to show you how you can create such a title block. We have already the frame for a layout maybe, and the frame could be created with the rectangle, and now we would create the title block. But of course you can use lines or polylines, but in this case I would like to show you how you can use the offset in the trim command, because all those lines, the vertical and the horizontal lines, are parallel to each other, and that's why it might be easier if you choose this workflow, which I would like to introduce you in this tutorial. At the end we would like to create two blocks, one for the frame and one for the title block. And we would like to insert it, and this we also would like to do in this tutorial. But let's start with this title block. So at first I would like to create those red lines, the frame for my title block. And here I prepared already a layer where it should be. This is the layer title block frame. I make this current, and now I would like to use those lines, those already exist as lines of my other frame, and I would like to duplicate them, or better to say, I would like to offset them. And before I can do this, I have to explode those polyline, because this is just a polyline. And if I offset this, then I would offset all the four lines, but actually I only need this vertical line for an offset and this vertical line for an offset, and that's why it might be better to explode it. So I select this polyline, and now I go to explode, and here now I have just four simple lines, and now we can offset it. And but before we can offset, we have just to look at what is the distance. So to create those red lines, of course here we have, so here we have this distance for this line from this 190, and distance between the blue line and the red one, and the distance between this blue line and this red one is 2 times 20, and 25 makes 65. So here we have 190, and here let's say 65. This we should take in consideration. So let's start with the offset. At first, I go here to the offset command, click on it. Oh, we are inside this command. And please always, if you use any command here in AutoCAD, please always take in consideration the parameters of the command, because there are some ways where how you can adjust the workflow that it better works in your case maybe. Yeah. Don't use all the time just the default settings. So here I would like to change the layer, because those new lines should be on another layer. That's why let's go to the layer parameter, and here we can this is the default. Default is source. Yeah, that means the layer, no, the lines will stay at the same layer, so they will stay blue in our case. But we would like to set those new lines to the current layer. So let's change this, click on current, and now they will be set to the current layer. And now it asks you the other things we can skip. This is okay. You can also maybe erase something if you would like to offset, but you can also change the line. But this is, I think, the most important parameter in our case now is the layer. And the next, we have to enter the distance here. And here we had already calculated the distance. This was 65 from this line. So let's say 65. And now click at this line. And now just the direction. You can click below the line. Then it will be the blue line. Then it will be here. But you can also click up here. This line, then it will be here. So with the cursor of your mouse, you can change the direction. And if you find it in the right direction, just give it a click, and now this line is created. Let's repeat this command. So I I finish this command with the hitting the spacebar on my keyboard, and again the spacebar will repeat this command. And now the layer setting, we can keep this is okay, but we have to change the distance because now I would like to create this line here. So the new distance would be 190. And now again, click at this line, and then the direction where it should be here. Okay, now I hit escape to finish the command, and I created those red lines. Let's do the same with those green lines. So, but before we can do this, maybe let's save some time. Maybe we can cut those lines here. Yeah, and then it would be better with the green lines. Then we have less to delete later. So, doing this, of course, you can click at this line, and then you have those grids here, and here you can move it down, of course, on the other side. But I would like to introduce another command. So let's don't use this workflow this time. I would like to introduce the trim command. With the trim command, you can also do this, and sometimes this might be a little bit in a more efficient way. Let's use the trim command. Hit on trim, and here, sorry, I did not now. And here, change the mode. Yeah, you have to use the mode quick mode. Yeah, this is the best way, because if you use the quick mode, then you only have to click at the part you would like to delete. Yeah, and then the line will be deleted between all the other lines which cross this line. Yeah, as if I hit at this line and click here, then it will be deleted. So now again, let's do this with the green lines. I change my layer to the title block fields, and we can again use the offset command, which is this one. And here we have 20, yeah, for this line, and then also 90. Let's start with those vertical line. So enter 90 for the distance. The setting we can still use from the other time we have used this command. There has nothing changed. So the direction, click on it, and again enter the spacebar, finish the command, hit the spacebar again to repeat it, and now it changed the distance to 20, and here we can click at this line, should be here, and this line should be here. Okay, now again let's trim all the line parts we don't need. We'll trim, and we don't need this one. And this we can click twice, but I can also show you some other options of this command. If you go to trim, then you can also choose the cutting edges. And if I click cutting edges and choose this line, then this will be my cutting edge. And if I click at this part, oh no, you have to hit enter. Yeah, because you can, of course, you can select several cutting edges. That's why you have to finish this subcommand. So hit enter. And now this is my cutting edge, and if I click at this part, then it will delete all the other lines. Yeah, if you don't set up the cutting edge, then every line can be a cutting edge which crosses your line. So let's click at this one, and we ready. The last part might be now to join all the lines which belong together. This we can do with the join command, and in our case, there's those two red lines and here those blue lines. So here let's go to modified, and here is the join command. And in our case, it's okay if we just select all the objects, because the green lines cannot be joined. And those blue lines, they are connected to each other and are at the same layer. Those red lines are also connected to each other and are also at the same layer. That's why they will be joined automatically, and the other lines will not be joined. That's why I can select everything, hit enter, and if I hover with my mouse over this line here, it's now a polyline. And here again, if I hover over it, you see it's also a polyline. And here, if I hover the green line, it's still a line. So this is nice. And the last part will be to create a block, two blocks, one for the frame and one for the title block. And if you create a block, I have to mention that normally, if you would like to create such a frame or a title block, it might be a good idea to put it on the layer zero. Yeah. Because then, if you put those driving elements at the layer zero, you have the advantage later if you insert it, then you can then it will automatically takes the properties of the current layer. Yeah, but if you set up a special layer like we do now, then it might be then it keeps this layer. Yeah, maybe let's here we put this on the layer zero. Yeah, and the other one we leave it at this layer. So layer zero. Now we don't see anything because the layer zero is maybe let's turn off the grid. Now we can see it. And now let's create the block. I go to insert, and here we can create a block. You can create an internal block or an external block. In our case, let's do an internal one. We only want to use this block in this drawing. We don't use it, want to use it external with other drawings. So let's create a new block and give it a name. The name can be frame. Start with the frame. And we have to pick a point, the insertion point, but I think this point is okay. This is the zero. So as I always used to say, if you draw something, it's a good idea if you start at the with one point on your drawing at the point 0, 0. Yeah, so done. Now I don't have to choose anything here. This is already okay. And yeah, select the objects. I select this polyline, hit enter, and here you have a preview, and here you see there's one object selected. It's one polyline, yeah, which combines four lines. Yeah, and you can here you can decide what you would like to do with this block. You would like to retain it as a polyline, you would like to convert it into a block, or you would like to delete it. Yeah, if you delete it, then these lines will be gone, but the block is still part at your drawing. Yeah, you only decide what will happen with this part which you from which one you would like to create a block. So now we have done this, and this we can ignore because we have no any text or something like this in our block. So scaling uniform, I don't think it's necessary. You can scale it as you want to, and you can also allow to explode it. This might be quite interesting. Yeah, set up the units if, mainly then if you would like to use it in some other drawings, then the units might be really important. And if you would like to add a hyperlink to it, then you can do this here. This is some space for in the description. If you would like to describe your block, in our case, I think this is already self-explaining. And if you would like to edit your block, then you can open it now directly if you finish this menu in the block editor. In this, in our case, we don't want to change anything, so we don't enable this option. So let's hit OK. And here we are. This is now changed. The question is why it's now at the layer title block. Ah, okay, because I inverted it into a block. Yeah, and that's why it became green, because this was my current layer. Yeah, and that's why this was converted. Now it's a block. Yeah, and if you hover over it, is it here? It doesn't. Yeah, now it's a block reference. Yeah, maybe if I undo it, just to show you the difference, if I undo it, and now this is polyline. Okay, let's do it again. Insert block, and in this case we don't want to convert into block, we would like to retain it. Yeah, I don't want to change it. This was okay. Select object, also okay, and the rest we can keep. Hit okay. The name must be, oh, I've forgotten the name. Of course the name is quite important. Let's call it frame. Hit OK, and now you see you still have this polyline, but if you go to insert, and here you see there's our frame. And if I insert this frame now, maybe here beside, let's have a look. This is our current layer, and if I go to insert, it takes the it will be at the current layer, yeah, and it also takes those properties from the layer, yeah, when it comes to the color and the line weight and the line type and so on, yeah. That's why if you like to create a block which takes the settings later from the current layer, then the block should be always at layer zero. So let's do the same with the title block. I go again to insert, create block. This time I call it title block. Title block. Okay, and the point and this time is not so good idea. So let's pick it. Let's take this corner and select the objects. Here I use this crossing here from the right down corner to the upper left corner. I hit the left mouse button here and then I leave the mouse button. And now all the objects which are crossed by my green rectangle will be selected, and hit enter to end the selection. I would like to retain it as well. Here I have four objects. Yeah, this was this one polyline and then those three lines. Here this is the view. The rest we can keep. Let's hit OK. And here this is still the line, but if you go to insert, here it's our title block. And let's insert the title block here. Yeah, we still have the layer title block as current layer, but if I insert the title block, then here this title block has its own layers. Yeah, it does not care about the title block layer. But maybe it's not a good idea to put it on this layer. Maybe let's use the layer dimension. Yeah, and here this keeps all its own layers, yeah. But you can still with all the properties, yeah, the color and the line weight. But if you turn off the layer dimension, yeah, it will also turn off this block, yeah. This is so it means that it has its own layers, yeah, and it has also some special layer, yeah, the current layer one, yeah. If you turn off, for instance, this. And it, oops, this is the current one. Let's go to zero. And here, let's turn off the title block fields. And they're also gone, yeah? Yeah, this you have to take in consideration, yeah? If you would like to create a block with its own layers, yeah, as a additional feature, yeah? Or if you would like to keep all the elements of your block at layer zero, and it will everything will be at the current layer, yeah, if you insert the block. This is a decision you have to make if you create such elements. So I think we're done so far. I thank you for your attention, and maybe I can see you in another tutorial. Goodbye.